I know I'm late, super late for this comparison. And by now, most of the vloggers, journalists would have already given you a readout of the spec sheets of both of these bikes. And also, both of them are very different in their genre of riding. But in India, things are different. Me and my friends have been talking about 390 and Interceptor 650 for a long time now. And we were like, there was so much equipment to offer, from headlight to the tires, to the ferocious pickup it has. The way KTM handles in corners, whoa, amazing. Everything has been shaped and added to this bike for a purpose or for a specific reason. And the throttle, it is an alien tech for many mechanics, and they fail to understand it. The TFT display, look like it's from Iron Man's garage. Brilliant engineers at KTM had figured out every aspect of riding for us. It has a supermoto mode, remember? The rear slide that has been killed in the name of safety is alive here in Duke. One look and you know that this bike is ready to be ridden hard. It surely is the most complete package you can buy today. On the other hand, there is Interceptor 650. Retro looking, easy going, not at all bothered about lean angles or quick shifting. Much to our observation, there was absolutely nothing great apart from the engine in this bike. Headlight is lit with a candle. Tires are skinny and not confidence inspiring. And they still are running on tubes. Old school? Well, they've taken it too far. Not that there are no options. But ex-Triumph team, hired by Royal Enfield, did not provide this alien tech to us mortals. Gear ratios left you hanging in the middle of the corner. Till now, I haven't been able to find the right suspension setting for it. Not to forget that it's fuck heavy, man. Making Interceptor the most incomplete package you could go for as of today. So we now know that KTM is better than Royal Enfield in every scientific and mathematical way possible. Also gives you more mileage per liter. But how in the world does Interceptor still outsells KTM month on month? Now that is an equation I could not solve with mathematics. You see, there is something missing here. Something we really cannot put our fingers on. Something intangible. You see, there is no me in it. Allow me to explain me here. See, the sheer incompleteness of this bike, Interceptor, is later built and modded as per what you want and what you need. A sense of expression of your own self through the bike. As if the bike was a canvas. This is an addictive and love-inducing activity. And this expression is what makes Interceptor more like a tailored suit, which a designer custom makes for your style and usage, whereas the Duke is a ready-made t-shirt you pick up at a mall. Now, there is nothing wrong with it. So if you're a person who wants to hop on and ride off in the sunset, go for a Duke and conquer every corner there is. But if you're a person who likes to express your emotions through your bike and not afraid of getting your hands dirty building it month by month, while harnessing the undying charm of this bike like it used to be, then 650 Twin is your thing. Peace out.